Hey, how are you? In this video, I will be using Laravel and I will be overwriting a route which is defined in a package. There are plenty of packages which provide some kind of admin panel or some additional functionality, and sometimes you might want to overwrite some of the URLs or replace some controller with your custom functionality. So right here I have a brand new installation of Laravel. And behind the scenes, I just updated my environment file with the MySQL connections. For the demo purposes, I will be using Laravel Telescope and I will try to overwrite one of its routes. So let's start with the installation first. Composer require Laravel Telescope. Next, we need to install the assets required for Telescope. So PHP artisan telescope install, and finally to migrate the database and the new tables that telescope uses, PHP artisan migrate fresh. Now when I open a browser and type telescope, you can see that we have this package running. Now let's try to overwrite one of the routes of telescope. So the first thing you might do is open the route file and try to just create a route with the same name. So the route I'm going to try to overwrite is telescope commands. And I'm just going to die below here. Now let's open the browser and try to see what's displaying on that route. And as expected, this does not work and Telescope is still publishing this route. So the reason that our route is not working is because the Telescope service provider is loaded after our routes. So the Telescope route is overriding the one that we have. And if we open app.php inside the config folder, we can jump to the provider section. Here you can see there is a telescope service provider, but this is the one in our source folder and is not the one inside the vendor folder which actually publishes the routes. So the one that we need to work with inside the vendor folder is automatically loaded, and this is because Laravel has this functionality of automatically discovering service providers of packages and loading them without additional work on your part. So we need to stop Laravel from doing this for our telescope package so we can have more control over what it's being loaded. We can do this from the composer JSON file. And if we jump to this line over here of the extra section, we can see that there is a Laravel key and a don't discover key. This is added so you can specify packages that you don't want Laravel to automatically discover. In our case, we don't want Laravel telescope to be loaded. So after adding this entry, we need to do composer dump autoload. You can see a list of the packages that are being discovered and telescope is not one of them. So we are successful. And by the way, if you don't want any package to be discovered, which I always do, you can just add a star here, but in our case this is enough. Now let's go back to the browser and hit refresh. You can see that we are successfully overriding the route that we want. But now let's check if the other routes are working, for example, walks. And you see that there is a 404 error, so our package is no longer working. We can easily fix this by loading the telescope service provider here. And we don't want this one from the app folder, which is already loaded. We want the Laravel telescope service provider. I will load this before the local provider. Now when I go to the browser and refresh, you can see that telescope is now working. This is the works page If I open the requests, they are working as well, and the commands is still our custom route that we created. This is one way of overwriting a route. Another way is with binding your own controller inside the application container. So let me quickly get back to the previous state of this route not working. Okay, and composer dump out load. Now when I refresh, this is loading the telescope route. Okay, so we mentioned that we need to replace a controller inside the application container. We can do this from the app service provider. Inside the register section, we want to get the application container and we want to bind our custom controller instead of the telescope controller. Now I did some digging and I'm prepared, so I know the home controller from the telescope namespace is the one that we need to replace. And let's create our own controller. PHP artisan make controller, and we're naming it telescope commands controller. So let's replace it with this one. Now when I open the browser and refresh, you can see we get an error because the index method that it's looking for does not exist. So let's open our telescope commands controller and we want to extend the home controller of telescope. Now we'll create a public function index which will override the one from the home controller. Here we just wanna var dump a message and let's return the index function from the parent so that the page works. Going back to the browser and refreshing, you can see everything works as expected, and at the top we have our var dump which shows us that we successfully have control over what we display on this route. This is all for this video. Thank you for watching. Let me know below in the comments if you have any questions or suggestions. Thanks again.